What's up, guys? Welcome back to Golf Simulator videos. We're back today with the SkyTrak Portable Golf Launch Monitor to show you what I consider a pretty significant update to the SkyTrak Golf Simulator software application. All right, we're going to be running the PC version today, but they do have mobile applications as well. But if you've seen my past videos, we covered the 4.0 update that they did, pretty significant update showing the graphics and some features. But something I noticed throughout the duration of testing SkyTrak out here on their range, especially on like driver, is that they may not have been accounting for spin decay. And according to this update, they were not, because they've now added spin decay properly to their algorithm to show you the proper ball flight of your shot. Now, those of you watching that may not know what spin decay is, let me explain. We'll use a driver shot as an example. Let's say that you hit a drive, 265 carry, 2300 back side spin, but let's say you knock it off the toe, or depending on what your path and your face are, you know, that ball is generating left side spin. All right, so the tilt axis, you know, the side spin axis of the ball is tilting, let's just call it a degree, all right, which in a translation to an RPM, it'd be a side spin, let's say, of 900. I'm not throwing out exact numbers, but let's say it had 900 RPM of left side spin. Well, when that ball takes off and starts flying 50, 100, 150 yards down there, all right, as it's flying, that 900 RPM number is actually going down. It's slowing down in the air. All right, it's losing spin as it flies. All right, where that algorithm before actually was a constant. So it was thinking that it was flying the entire 250 some yards with exactly 900 side spin the entire flight, causing it to go too far left, all right? It would curve too far to the left more than it should. Where now spin decay, as the ball flies, that number is getting less, not causing as much of a left or right, you know, curve to the ball. So very important to understand, you know, and obviously you want to be able to see that shot shape, you know, correctly. So it's cool that they've made this update, and it's exciting we're going to be able to show it to you today, because we're actually going to use the UNEEKOR EYE XO to compare. You can see on the left side there, I'm using that view software. This is a $10,000 overhead mounted dual camera infrared launch monitor, all right? You know, $10,000 versus, you know, more affordable $2,000 unit, but both camera based, you know, both using photometric technology. So understand that. I have the unit, you know, perfectly level, the roll, the tilt, the alignment, all that stuff. So we're good to go there. If for some reason you guys are looking to purchase a SkyTrak unit, I just want to throw this out there now. I've been helping so many people, you know, get these units, whether it's just a standalone or full packages with, you know, turf and screens and projectors and everything else. It's been really cool. People sending me pictures and videos of their setups and their garages and basements and everything. I want to make sure you guys are getting the lowest price, the, obviously the best components that you need, you know, for your setting. Make sure you shoot me an email. I'll put it in the top of the comments and in the description. Shoot me an email. I'd love to hook you up with my partners. That way you're getting the lowest price, you know, saving on shipping, tax, all that stuff. You know, make sure that you shoot me an email. All right. Love to help out. And it helps support the channel, which I appreciate. So I think we're good to go. You know, I made a couple swings, so hopefully I'm a little warmed up. I think that the tough part here is honestly, if I'm going to be able to throw out some shot shapes that you want to throw out, because I usually just hit the same shot all the time. But I think I'm capable of doing it, because we want these balls almost to slice and hook, you know, to have heavy side spin to see if it's decaying properly. And, you know, you're seeing the same flight with the two different softwares. So first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to aim just a little bit left. I'm just going to kind of weaken my grip just a little bit. And I'm going to try to have just a little bit of an outside in path here if I can, and maybe a little bit open face, and get this ball to curve to the right. Only thing, is it gonna, yeah, I was gonna say, I was a little worried because it was just a little off center hit. Just kind of toward, not a toe ball, but just a, I could feel that it was just a little off center, but not too bad. Perfect little push for you guys. All right, started off to the right and then had right side spin on it, okay? 265 carry versus 251 carry. Now, I noticed this when I hit a couple balls early on, that the carry seems to be shorter on SkyTrak. I don't know why. And then what's weird is of course, the total is almost, you know, somewhat close. I don't pay attention to total. I pay attention to carry. I think that's the number you really want to look at, because it's a simulated rollout. I mean, who knows what you're landing in, right? You're landing on a hill or rough or whatever it may be. So I always look at carry. Spin was very close. 2116, 2105. Ball speed, real close, 1 mile an hour different. Launch angle, 1.7 higher on IXO. Side spin, 367 right versus 335 right. Okay, close. What I'm looking at though is the trace. I mean, the trace is almost identical. So I'd say that they've nailed it. I mean, on the, of course, I shouldn't say that on the first shot. I mean, the first couple shots I hit that you guys didn't see, they looked very similar. So, I mean, based on what I'm seeing so far, the first couple drives that I hit, and then now seeing that, you know, it sure seems like they have the proper, you know, algorithm adjustment, you know, in there. So let's go ahead and hit one more. I think I'm going to try to do a little more of a normal drive for me. Okay. So I'm not going to aim to the left. I'm going to strengthen my grip up just a little more. And we're going to try to get this ball to curve to the right. I'm sorry, left. Did I close it down enough? Ball's curving to the left. All right. On both of them, too. It wasn't a perfect strike. I was a little worried. But 265 carry versus 255 carry. Ball speed identical, 154, 154. Backspin only 100 higher on SkyTrak. Side spin. So it says center. It didn't catch any side spin, but I was left 254 on IXO, and of course it ended up left of the center line. So we just missed side spin, maybe, potentially? Was it just a little miss on the SkyTrak unit? That might be one of the first times I guess it was a pretty minimal side spin number on the IXO. What was it, 264? But it ended up left of center line, where the SkyTrak had it just a little bit of a push. You could see the side angle of 3 degrees, and then 1.3 degrees on IXO. So just a little more of almost like a straight, you know, straight ball on SkyTrak, you know, just going down the right of the center line. So let's get another one down there. As always, I always have my videos uncut. I want to show you guys exactly what I'm seeing. So try to make a similar setup here. The goal is to draw the ball. That was low. Not going to launch the way I like it. But it looks like both of them are curving to the left. All right. So we got 253 carry versus 253 carry. We have a same carry number now, both with little side spin to the left, 248 versus 212. All right, 2969 versus 3233. So a little discrepancy in backspin, but not that much. 1.6 high on the launch angle. I'm seeing that as kind of a consistent number. IXO has a higher launch. But overall, look at the trace. Looks the same to me. I need to get a little more of like a heavy draw. And that wasn't a great strike. I mean, it's a good example. I mean, I definitely want to show all kinds of different, you know, examples for you guys. So let's see if I can, I mean, I guess we could just try a hook if you guys want to see a hook. That just wasn't a great strike is all. Did I close that one down enough? Am I hitting these drives too good? I mean, it only had left 275 on IXO. Look at the flight though. It's the same. 266 carry versus 262. So I wonder what's up with that. It's almost like the push, you know, fade type ball is what was much different in, you know, in the algorithm. But the backspin was 2910 versus 2606. These spin numbers are a little higher than I normally spin the ball. So not quite the same contact I'm used to. 157 ball speed versus 154. A little different there. Side spin was really close, and the shape, from what I can see, is pretty close. I mean, it looks like SkyTrak had it taking off a little bit to the right again versus IXO. And I have it lined up. I mean, I did some chipping and different things to make sure it was lined up. I mean, I could, and if I look inside the sim too, it's even, you know, everything lines up perfectly. But, you know, that might be one of those situations where if that was a constant, if it was a degree or two to the right, maybe we just need to turn the SkyTrak unit just a little bit. But does that really matter as far as like the side spin and the spin decay for what we're looking at today? No, I mean, both of them had a similar shape, which is very important. Launch angle, once again, look at 1.7 higher on the iXO. That's becoming a constant from what I can see there. So let's try it again. Let's hit another fade. Let's weaken the grip up. I'll aim a little left again. I'm interested to see that carry distance. Even if it's a slice. Did I leave it open enough? Oh yeah. So 267 versus 259. And then it says it was center versus 0.1. So there you go. They both took off down the center line that time. There was no discrepancy as far as launch direction. Spin 2698 versus 2710. I'm finding this hilarious because I usually spin the ball closer to like 2200, sometimes even sub 2000. These aren't the normal knuckleballs I normally hit, but it's okay. I mean, I'm adjusting a bunch of stuff. Side spin 289 versus 390. A little bit heavier on the side spin as far as you know, the SkyTrak unit goes, and only 0.9 higher on the launch angle that time. All right. So this is very interesting. Very interesting. I'll tell you what, I'd love to know what you guys think. I always like to know what the actual users out there that are using the units think, along with what you're seeing, you know, here inside of the studio. I didn't really warm up a lot. I'd like to try to get after a couple drives and get them way out there, you know, with that knuckleball I'm used to hitting. See if I can hit a neutral drive here and try to get one down there. Tried to swing a little harder at that one without, oh yeah. Well, I swung a little harder. It says 274, 156 ball speed, and look at the curve. Side spin was 841 and 817. So you can see, obviously, let that rip a little bit harder. And, you know, I'm starting to, but look, why is it 256 carry versus 274 though? A 156 ball speed? It's carrying further than 256, you know, and that's pretty normal for me outdoor. You know, if I'm getting around 160, I'm carrying it 275. You know, that's pretty normal. I'm not putting these in a flight algorithm. I'm kind of just going off my hip, but 1841 backspin versus 1844, really close. Only 0.7 higher too, as far as IXO goes. Launch direction, 1.6 to the right versus 3 degrees to the right. So just a little bit higher launch direction on that one. Hey, I'm really glad I kind of swung after that though. And I got a little bit lower spin, which my goal was. And then I got a big curve, you know, which is what we're trying to do. I mean, I want the ball to have curve on it because we're looking at spin decay. All right. So I know we're going, you know, over 13 minutes here on the video. So I'm going to hit one more for you guys. That wasn't a bad swing. I just really can't get after it right now. I weakened the grip up a little bit there, and you can see it going a little bit to the right now. 269 carry, 263 carry. Getting closer again. Like I said, a little more spinny than I want. 2772 and 2731. Or if that weaker grip has a big effect on that. 157 ball speed, 155. I mean, I am in literally like leather dress shoes, you know, doing this video. Not sure if you guys are noticing that or not. They're like a slick bottom. I mean, we're just trying to make decent swings here. We can do another video later if you guys think it's worth it, but check out the side spin number, 78 versus center. All right. You know, so both those flights, I mean, you had a little bit further right, I would say, on SkyTrak, because that 2 degree to the push to the right, and notice the side angle on IXO. The launch direction was zero. So once again, we're just getting a little bit of a further launch direction to the right on the SkyTrak unit. Could it be alignment? I can mess with that. But I mean, I did the same process I always do. And, you know, I generally have a pretty good launch direction. So, you know, could it be just slightly off? It's possible. I'll let you guys kind of be the judge of that. So there's those numbers. I'm really interested to see what everybody's results are as far as these carry numbers go. Like I said, on that particular one, it wasn't too far off, 263 versus 269. But I mean, it's getting up there, you know, 7 to 10 plus yards we saw on some of those. And it's always shorter. And I feel like based on ball speed, launch direction, spin, all those type of parameters, I feel like the carry distance is a little light. You know, but like I said, I'm usually spinning that ball quite low. That one draw, I finally got it down there into that 1800, 1900, where I like to hit the knuckleball if I can with this new driver. That's a Sim 2 driver with a Ventus black shaft, just so you guys understand. That was that new driver that I got. Really interested to see what you guys think about this new SkyTrak algorithm update. All right, this is a Spin Decay update, version 4.1 for the SkyTrak portable golf launch monitor. Figured I'd throw together a quick video for you guys to show you what it's like comparing with another unit. I think the UNEEKOR EYE XO is a good one to compare to. You know, love to hear what you guys think. So make sure you comment below, let me know. I'll make sure to do more testing. You know, if for any reason I feel like I could get this set up better, you know, because like I said, that launch direction was a little bit to the right, I will do that. I'll make sure to comment below if I find anything. But I had it set up as always, you know, with the center alignment, did some testing, made sure the roll and the tilt and everything were level. Looks like it's performing quite well, actually. I mean, like I said, you also have to understand, we're talking about $2,000, you know, more affordable unit versus $10,000. So do understand that. Love to hear what you guys think. Comment below. As always, I appreciate you guys watching. Stay tuned. There'll be a lot more coming soon.